The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Oh, look who we have.
It's a beautiful thing. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We are taken by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy camo! I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. We're in holiday trading, folks. Bottom line, though, markets are open. Markets are at all-time highs. Serve the one you love. Once you decide to be a couple, you have to serve the one you love, to serve your love to your lover. And every kiss and every touch you feel there to please the one you love without expecting anything back. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 57, up 47, trading at 28.56. NASDAQ up 55, and get this, folks, 9,007. It broke 9,000, monster number. I think when I basically was starting this business, the NASDAQ was about 600, rather. Not even 900. Pretty sick. Big numbers. NDX 100, that's up 56, trading at 87.86. Gold contract up $10.80, trading at 15.15 an ounce. You got silver up 14 cents, $17.99 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 58 cents, $61.69 a barrel. Notes and bonds. You got the 10-year up 3 ticks, 128.13. 30-year up 7 ticks, 156.19. And King Dollar down 97 ticks, trading at 97.535. The euro is at 111 to 1 U.S. dollar. The yen is at 109.62. And the pound is at 130 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Let's call, folks. I know what's going on in y'all world. We're going to the world of the NASDAQ composite first, because you got Amazon firing and all cylinders out here. This is what's putting the big juice into the composite, as well as the NDX 100. Composite's up $54 right now. You're at 9,007. And if we go over to Amazon, you're going to see this baby. You know, I've been talking about it a lot, that it's just been laying there. And guess what? It's laying there until it doesn't lay there. Amazon closed Tuesday at 1789, and you are at 1866. This has wide price spread, has volume also, and it's pretty amazing for a holiday week. It's going after the swing point up here, blew it away actually of 1853, and you blew it away with volume. That's saying that Amazon's on its way up to 2035, and let me just see if that's the high. No, it's not. It's 50 is the high. So we're going after now the last swing high from July of 2019. That had failed as it was going after the high from September of 2018. But bottom line is that, guess what? It's got some juice underneath it. And I suspect that's going to be, let's see, Amazon stock in the biggest advance in the S&P index after the e-commerce giants had its holiday season this year was record-breaking, with billions of items shipped and tens of millions of Amazon devices like Echo Dot sold. Yeah, the more they get sold, folks, the Echoes, the more that, of course, it's just a natural buying inside people's houses. They got 5 million new customers that started Prime free trials. That's a big number. Paid memberships globally, while the number of items that were delivered with one day or same day shipping quadrupled. Look at that, quadrupled compared to last season. Holy cow. Independent third-party sellers sold more than 1 billion items. Monster numbers all around. That's the real bottom line. This is like just a monster number. Let's see what they're going to be coming out with numbers. So they're coming out with numbers January 30th. Also, inside the NDX 100, well, let's go over to Apple, because Amazon is the biggest mover inside the NDX 100. NetEase, which is a Chinese internet company, is shopping site, is number two. That's up, and then Apple. Apple, I think it's up about $4.50. Yeah, $4.57. And bottom line is that this is not only at an all-time high, this had big juice last week. Last week, yeah, pretty amazing, actually. Yeah, option expiration was coming in. But, man, this has been a one-way move by Apple. You know, when you look at Apple, this is about as sick as you get. January 4th of 2019, Apple traded at $142, and you're $288. So there you go, 100%. You know, as of today, I think it was up a little less than that. But the bottom line, that's almost unheard of, that you have a company that's a billion-dollar company being up 100% in 1 year. Pretty amazing. Notes and bonds. Let's go take a look at the note and bond market. If we have the 10-year note first, we take a look at it. You're up two ticks. You got light volume. It's holding price out here today, so we'll see how that shakes out. It didn't hold price last, let's see, what day is today? So today's Thursday, last Monday. Monday it didn't hold price. We go take a look at the 30-year right now. Also up six ticks. Shot volume, we know we have light volume all around inside the note and bond market. So what I'd really like to see, I was looking for a test of the lower end of this consolidation because the way that we had failed on price and volume on Monday, it failed. Dollar index, you get a little selling inside the dollar. And what that is that you have the euro catching a small bid. We're up 11 ticks inside the euro. And we'll see whether that can get into some real juice going topside. Pound, same type of setup. Pound right now also is trading up about 42 ticks. Pound actually looks like it can actually go again. You know, the pound, last 10 days, after Johnson got elected and a decisive victory, the pound had gone, started out at 130, got all the way up to 135, and then imploded at 135. 5 days later, went down to 129. Now, inside the currency market, folks, that is like just a five. You don't get down five pennies in currency markets in 5 days. Guess what? It did. And, you know, we'll see whether it can make its gains going back topside once again. Inside the gold market, GDX, HUI, XAU, they're all catching a bid. Bottom line, they're catching a good bid, too. GDX is trading $29. That's looking to go to 30 bucks up here. We go to the XAU. We take a look at the XAU. We put this on a monthly, and what you're going to be seeing here is that you're launching the swing high from the 16th, from 2016. That's what it's going after. You're 7 points away from it right now. We're at $114. The swing point is at $114.71. We're at 105. Stay right there, folks. Come back with our man, Mr. Basil Chapman. We'll be talking markets out here.